While watching T-Bot 9, I came to the realization that this challenge was not like any other BFDA challenge at all. I'm not talking about the fact that the challenge was very unique and creative, but about how out of control the challenge was. Two did not have control over the challenge at all, but instead, the challenge had control over Two, which is very scary if you think about it, since things could have easily taken a wrong path here, without Two being able to fix anything. The only reason the good ending even happened is because of multiple coincidences that happened at the perfect timing, such as Teardrop going to the room where GB and TB were at the perfect time, which helped in finding the cure for the disease. Another example is the event of Snowball eating Yo-Yo Berry in T-Bot 6, which is also another factor of the good ending happening. Snowball ate the Yo-Yo Berry and became heavy, so Bell asked him to go down due to how heavy he was, which caused his death and caused him to become infected by the virus, then was turned into a giant snowball, and because of that, the virus cure managed to reach the ass who went and spread the cure around to fix everything. But what if one thing went wrong? What about the bad ending that could have happened? Imagine if Teardrop got stuck here instead of where she actually got stuck in. I do believe that whoever tries to bite Teardrop will probably turn back to normal, but that wouldn't matter since Teardrop got trapped. There were a lot of infected contestants around her, so even if any of them turned back to normal, they would have got bitten again, or would have survived by a miracle. And even if they survived, the event of Teardrop falling inside Barf Bag wouldn't have happened, and thus Golf Ball and Tennis Ball wouldn't have found the cure for the virus, and would have got infected by Barf Bag. And not only them, but most of the contestants would have got infected by the virus too, excluding some contestants who are capable of escaping, such as Black Hole, Robot Flower, and others. If that actually happened and the cure never made its way to the ass, then it would be in 4, X, and Clocks' hands to fix everything. But how would they even do that? Just like 2 got infected by the virus, 4 could too, even with the power he has. 4 and X don't have it easy, since there are many contestants, including flying contestants and 2, who are gonna go after them and try to infect them. We are talking here if they realize that everyone is infected. What if they don't realize it? Just like when Ben didn't realize that Barf Bag was not normal at first. So why would 4 and X know that they should avoid being close to the contestants? Only way they could know is if they saw Clock being bitten and infected, or if any of the surviving T-Bot contestants tell them. But they would still need to find a cure and try to solve the problem. Killing them wouldn't fix it since 2 is also infected. They can't kill 2, who literally can teleport whenever they want. In addition to that, we don't know if killing the contestants would even fix anything at all, which means 4, X and Clock have barely any chance of fixing this mess. What about the eliminated contestants? 2 would teleport an infected contestant to them at some point, similar to how they teleported GB, TB and Gaty, and then the eliminated contestant would get infected too. If 4 and X got infected somehow, which is somewhat likely, then it's game over. The only contestants that can save us now are the BFE boss split contestants, and if Golf Ball couldn't fix it without the help of Locke, then how would the boss split contestant fix it? There is absolutely no chance they are capable of fixing something that 2, Golf Ball and 4 couldn't fix. It's crazy to think about this scenario, which was very likely to happen, and nearly happened. The hopeless reality of the T-Bot 9 bad ending is very scary.